Hi friends, I'm Kazel and today we're going to talk about how to take a screenshot on your iPad Pro or any iPad that you have. Taking a screenshot on your iPad can be incredibly useful for several reasons. One of them is to capture information. Screenshots allow you to capture and save important information displayed on your iPad screen, and this could include important documents, web pages, receipts, error messages, and more. So whether you're a beginner or a seasoned user of the iPad, I will be sharing with you all the different ways to capture those perfect screenshots. So let's get started. The first one, which is the easiest way to take a screenshot on your iPad, is by using the physical buttons. To capture a screenshot, locate the power button on the top right corner of your iPad and the volume button located on the right side. If your iPad has a home button, you will be using the power button and the home button. Press and hold both buttons simultaneously. You will see a brief flash on the screen indicating that the screenshot has been captured. The thumbnail will show here, and if you just slide in to the left, it will automatically be saved in your Photos app. If you have an Apple Pencil, you can also use it to capture your screen. To do that, swipe up diagonally from the bottom corner of the screen toward the opposite corner. This gesture can be used as a shortcut to capture your screen. In the case that this is not working, go to the settings menu of your iPad and then go to the Apple Pencil setting. Scroll to the bottom and in the pencil gestures, you can set the action that will occur when you swipe diagonally using your Apple Pencil. I have set the left corner swipe to be used for screenshot. Now let's do the gesture again. After taking a screenshot, there are other things that you can do to optimize and to customize the screenshot you have captured. So let's start in the upper left corner. If you tap done, you'll have the options to save the screenshot to your photo library, save it in your files, or save it as a quick note. If you don't want to save it, you can either use the options copy and delete screenshot or just delete the screenshot. This slider here allows you to control the opacity of the screenshot. For the options on the upper right side, this icon here is for the text recognition. If you want to use it, just tap the icon. This allows you to extract text from the screenshot. You can then copy the text if you want to. If you want to highlight or write something on the screenshot you just took, you can use the markup tool. And using the writing tools available, you can write, highlight, or even draw on your screenshot. The next icon is the delete screenshot option, and the rightmost one is the sharing icon. All the sharing options are available similar to when you are sharing any other files or pictures. Also, if you are taking a screenshot of a web page, additional options are available. You can choose to just capture the image in your screen, or you can choose to capture the entire page. If full page is selected, you can customize the cut or the area you want to save. And that is for the additional actions that you can do after taking a screenshot. There is also another way that you can take a screenshot in the iPad. And this one is using the assistive touch. To enable assistive touch, go to settings, then tap on accessibility. Under the physical and motor section, select touch and tap on assistive touch, and then toggle it on. Once enabled, a floating button will appear on your screen. Tap on it and then select device and then more. You can find the screenshot option here and then just tap it to use it. So let's recap on the different ways you can take a screenshot on the iPad. The first one is using physical buttons. You can also use the Apple Pencil if you have one. And lastly is using the assistive touch for easier accessibility. If you're interested on the 9 different ways you can use the split screen in the GoodNotes app, you can watch this video. And I'm Kazel, and thank you for watching. Until next time, bye!